this is a rare kind of magic. I'll need to write to headquarters right away. So, anything interesting for me? I'll take that as a no.
Oh, my. These smelling salts are strong stuff. Why won't you sing?
Ah, there you are, wife. Would you please tell this very charming gaggle of not at all brat-like babes that I am by no accounts this loser woman, nor do I sing, in fact. I'm deathly, deathly allergical. How very correct you are, spouse of mine. Madame Josephine Gribbles de Peeb refuses to be confused with anyone else. What? What's so funny?
Her pinched face cracks into a great grin, and she shoos the children away from her with a laugh.
Yeah, okay, you found me.
She turns to you.
Gotta keep ourselves entertained, haven't we? You presume right. Thanks, but I already belong to an elite and exclusive ship gang. We play ball every day after lunch. You're too soft for it. You take care, though. Nope, trying not to find anything out either. Ignorance is bliss. The utterer, the better.
Suddenly, her eyes cloud to an unnatural black. Greyish, as quickly as the...
Good luck, Chief.
And water are all I was given.
Unacceptable. I've never dined on anything less than a dozen-course dinner, and I don't intend to do away with the custom.
Well, there has been a murder, Your Majesty.
The elf is reading a volume of Cranley Hubert's famous encyclopedia. He reaches up. He sits back.
I am... My book is in my...
He grabs him.
No, they are working quite... Oh! You have my apology. Perhaps I should demand... Perhaps. Take this book. It is simul... Tell me. Oh, please. I have no interest... No. I want to know about the celestial. This text. Where did these gods come from? Who are they? Of course you don't have any... Now, please, run along.
No amount of pestering will get the elf...
Put a knuckle in it. I'm trying to concentrate.
You mind? I'm really rather busy.
Give you that knuckle if you keep carrying on.
One of us would kill our own. They're picking us off one by one.
Forget it. Can we just skip to the part where I reassure you and you shut up?
You think me mad?
Mad? No. Insufferable.
An elf sits tucked away in a
Snake eyes.
She chuckles.
I bet that's just what they'll look like. Rolling dice. Deciding fates. Don't worry, honey. It isn't yours.
She looks you up and down with the merest hint of a coy smile on her...
Never say never, though.
She eyes you quite seriously.
Not the future, no. But I can read the past in flesh. One of the perks of being an elf, you see. I'm quite good at it, too. I could lick your arm and tell you how you spent the night before last. Shall I?
She gives your arm a vigorous stroke of...
You were in a cellar... With other sorcerers. As everyone lay sleeping, you lay awake, thinking of someone back home. You were... reminiscing.
She pats you on the shoulder.
There, there, don't you worry, darling. I don't lick and tell.
Put a knuckle in it. I'm trying to concentrate.
They don't care about us. We're like cattle.
I'll give you that knuckle if you keep carrying on.
One of us will be our own. One by one.
Can we just skip to the part where I reassure you and you shut up?
You think me mad?
I'll tell you if...
So, anything interesting for me? I'll take that as a no.
I've never dined on anything less than a dozen course dinner, and I don't intend to do away with the custom.
Well, there has been a murder, Your Majesty. Maybe that has the Magister's more concern than more appetite.
Here's the Register, ma'am. Good, good. Magister Williams has just about done with the last passenger. You faring okay so far? Trust me, with Bishop Alexander in charge, things will get a lot better from here on out. He's godwoken, you know. You head on in now. Williams will get you sorted fast.
Keep those bumps trained on her. And if she tries to run, shoot to kill.
You seem on edge, officer. You seem on edge, officer. What on earth is the
murder most foul? And I strongly suspect murder most foul.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she...
So you admit it, then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God! The woman's mad! You there, sorcerer! Go and fetch Magister Siwan! We need to do more than collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
It means your journey draws to a close. Do stick around for its finale, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, men, quickly! If she casts source, the Voidwoken will come. They'll end us all.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
The dwarf lies in a heap on the floor, his great beard twisted and tangled around him. He is stock still. You can't see if he's living or dead. You hear a faint thud, thud, thud. He's alive, but only just.
Need to get off this wreck, and quick!
The marking on the door was painted recently, judging from its pungent scent. You recognize the symbol immediately for what it is. You press your palm against the door to open it. It doesn't budge. The door groans open.
kin. Children and dwarves first, just like the old stories say.
The dwarf yanks at one of the nearby ropes to no avail.
You said there were other people down there.
You see those tentacles, kid? It's time for getting the hell out of here.
Thank you, thank you, thank you! There's a ladder right over there. You can go straight down.
You're gonna be the death of us, you hear?
Honorable Dallas, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwoken. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan.
Voidwoken made short bloody work of the ship. Am I the lone survivor? It seems someone, something, wanted me alive. Thank you. thought the Order would get rid of any trace of the old source code.
The child has a small mirror in his hands. He holds it up at angles, inspecting his eyes, his chin, the crown of his head. He spots you, and his arms snap to his sides.
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers. Why? I guess. But the people who put me here are human, and the people who took my parents away are human too. Or do you mean because I'm a... Are you a sorcerer? One of those guys that brings the bad void things here?
The child looks at you straight on, unafraid, searching your face. He lifts his mirror to his nose, closes one eye, and looks at himself again.
I don't see any source on you or me. I guess they're wrong or crazy. Maybe you're right. At least they don't mind where anyone goes. They know we can't leave the island, and it's a lot nicer out here than inside. They're gone now. The Magisters took them already. I guess now they're cured. And maybe they're waiting for me back at home. But you didn't die. I guess I am, but it's just normal to be scared. Nowhere isn't scary. There isn't anywhere safer. That's what I mean. You'll see.
Voidwoker. The same beast that sank our ship. Made it to shore. Drowned and eaten by a Voidwoken. I wonder in which order.
You spot a strange lizard. Yes, you recognize him from the ship. It would seem you're not. The lizard turns about.
I did survive, yes. You have my...
Hand over heart, he salutes you with a bob of the...
My gratitude is worth... Now then, if there's nothing further.
He watches you depart without a word, then turns back to face the sea. The cat's eyes are clouded and grey, but it stares at you with acute intensity. Its eyes clear, and it shakes its head, confused.
Lady, it's a lot nicer here than that stinking boat, huh? I'm sure glad you went back to save the others. Saw one of them wringing out their tunic at the shore a few hours ago. Say hi for me. I never want to set foot on a stuffy old boat ever again. Never. Thank you.
Stay back, sorcerer, and stay silent. Our Godwoken speaks.
We know you've been helping sorcerers escape, Atusa. We have proof.
I'd sooner cut my tongue out than lie to you, Alexander. I know nothing of any escapees.
If you can tell the Godwoken no more, your tongue is of no use. Cut it out.
This can't be serious, Alexander. Come!
You should know by now to obey your superior, Magister, whatever she may ask.
Atusa pinches the tip of her tongue with two fingers and brings her dagger to its root. Her eyes squeeze shut. Drops of blood form against the dagger's edge and quickly fall to the ground. She groans.
Stop! My father, may his soul rest in peace, would be disappointed in you, Atusa. To think you would lie to his only son, your bishop, and your friend these many years. The fate of our realm hangs in the balance. If you will not help us save it, then you will help the Void destroy it, Dallas.
Yes, Your Holiness.
I believe we're done here.
What a waste. Come, we'll be needed elsewhere.
Saw him, didn't you? The hammer and Alexander. They gave that scaly traitor what for, they did. We'll see how long that lasts.
Come on,
stay down,
you.
Hey, I know you.
Losa, the dark-eyed jokester you met aboard the ship, waves enthusiastically and dips into a mock elegant curtsy.
Back then I was Madame Josephine Gribbles de Pube. And you were... you. Glad to see you made it. Nothing like a nice tentacle slap across the moor to set the tone for the week, eh? How'd you escape? Me too. Did you hear something? When you were in the water, I mean.
I heard the same thing. Do you know what this means? It means I'm not the only...
Losa's voice catches in her throat. The joy drains from her face. Her eyes lose focus and her whole body goes rigid. She is stock still, waxy-skinned, her eyes dark. Greyish-black veins run from her eyes down her cheeks. Her head snaps to you mechanically, and her eyes lock with yours, dark pupils dilated into great black voids. Light suddenly flashes back into her face. The grey veins drain to pinkish flesh, and her whole body relaxes.
Anyway, what were we talking about? Ah, it's nothing really. It's just... I'm just a bit... well, a bit... hospitable? Put it like this. You've never been a host, I bet. That's because you're an infested clump of leaves on the side of the road. That ain't bad, though. I'd give just about anything to be like you. But I'm a roadside inn. Red door, flowers out front, friendly lady at the door beckoning you in for half price.
Like a goddamn gold star inn for the disembodied. Now, isn't that just the question of the hour? I can't be sure just yet. I'll be surprised if it's a demon. Definitely not a sprite either. Maybe a spectre, but I wouldn't bet money on it. So, how are you enjoying the joy? Yeah, same story here. Reckon in my case, they might actually be right, though. So, you want to check this place out together? Strength in numbers and all that. It does, right? Before we head out, I've got more than a few tricks up my sleeve, so you'll have to pick which one I'll pull out if, when, push comes to shove. Lately, I've been into the enchanting arts, but I can shoot, slash, summon, steal, whatever your little black heart desires. So, what'll it be? I don't know if you could tell, but mysticism's kind of my speciality. Let's get into the nitty-gritty while we're at it. What sort of magic are you interested in? Sounds fine. So, we're good to go? Yeah? Well, that was easier than I thought. And I'll do my best to stay myself. Lead the way.
Have you, cud?
Disgusting. Just like all your kind.
Disgusting like theft. Disgusting like threats.
Great God. Will you quit dragging this on? Train that hard, Lexi. Just hand over the goal.
bow your head, please. If we chant the endless prayer, the next divine will ascend.
Come on then, Lexi. Play up.
I find Danny's right. I want no trouble.
Bread or brisket, toast the same.
Your grift teaches you to bully others. Pathetic.
You keep his name out of your mouth, you filthy cunt, you are. Just like all your kind.
Disgusting like death. Disgusting like threats.
Haven't you heard? Bishop Alexander, do not doubt that he will come in.
I will not.
This is not your business, Long Pig.
Don't let this moss muncher talk to you like that. Especially a cheapskate like this'un. Griff already knows she don't like to pay her fair share.
An intense-looking man steps between the thug and the elf and rolls up his sleeves, revealing well-muscled and heavily scarred arms.
Just stand aside, won't you, mate? This is no business of yours.
Lone wolves decide their own business.
The thug freezes in fear for a moment before shuffling back to the protection of his crony.
Pay up, elf. No one shorts Griff, especially not one of you.
The intense-looking man stands beside you against the thugs, shooting you an appraising glance. Burrow looks you both up and down, sizing up your combined threat.
Ah, get out of here. The both of you. You ain't worth a sweat on my brow anyhow.
The elf smiles and bows to you in thanks.
Follow me, before more of them trouble us. There is a safe place.
Reprieve from the din outside.
Thank you for your help with that thug. Rare is the human who goes against their own for an elf.
She bows.
I hear of no escapes. The only way out is through. Through the Magisters, through their cure. Thugs, I can stand, but oh, I fear the Magisters. In this cave, we trust the healer. She is young, but she sees. She knows more than we know. In the camp, the brute Griff rules. He who gives the bread has the power. It gives me great pain. I'm with my family. We are making beautiful magic. We are healing a tree cut down with great violence. The Magisters come. My family runs, but I fall. My son looks back. I shout to him to run. I am taken. Wait, before you go. I am not here without your help. I do not forget this. For you, a prize. I save it for a special occasion, but I can think of no finer occasion than this. Thank you.
my unlikely friend. What do you need?
As you approach the young elf...
Hey, listen, I don't know why, but I think I need to talk to this elf. You mind?
She jerks her hand away.
I just need to talk to her, okay?
She turns towards Sahela. She darts over to the elf without responding. They begin talking in earnest, more quietly than you can overhear. Losa suddenly snatches up both the elf's hands and leans close to her. Her voice rises.
You have to tell me.
The whites of Losa's eyes fade to grey, then black. The colour runs into her veins, crisscrossing her skin like lightning. She keeps hold of Sahela's hands.
It rises in you even now, Losa. Do not let it. You must be strong. Be strong. Fight. Fight. You are okay. You are yours. No one else's.
Shut up. Let go. Let go. Let go. I don't want to hurt her. Don't make me.
Losa is rigid as a board, tense with the effort of holding Sahela's hands in tight, painful bunches.
Leave me alone! Leave me! I don't want to!
You are hurting me.
Losa's eyes are black. Sahela's fingers are white under her grasp.
Let me go! Please!
A sinister smile spreads across Losa's lips. She jerks the elf toward her.
Chatty, chatty elf. Chatty elf with all the answers. I wonder what your blood tastes like.
Losa, please. You must not defend her. She wakes if she is weakened. We must hurt her to protect her, you see?
I bet the elf blood tastes like honey, like nectar, like joy itself. Let's find out.
You must weaken her to help her.
Don't look at me like that. Good. I don't. Let's keep moving. I want to get out of this bloody place as soon as possible. I'm fine. You're fine. We're fine. I just want to get out of here. Let's go.
The young girl's eyes are covered, but she turns toward you when you approach. She smiles as though she recognizes you, though she couldn't have seen your face.
Ah, hello. I see you come a long way. I see you come here seeking a great adventure.
She laughs and looks around as though taking in the scenery, though her eyes are still covered.
Many people to meet, many stones to turn. And there is a great joy here, as though the walls and water themselves were made by many smiling gods. Even if we are here under unhappy circumstances, still I feel it. I do not mean to disturb you. It's just... Never mind. How do I help you? Yes, please ask. It is safer here. We make no trouble for Griff. Oh, I do not cover my eyes. I cover the place they used to be. They are gone now, taken. But I see all the same. He is a very blind man. He sees things, but not truth, not love or joy. I feel very sorry for him. You understand when you meet him. After you escape. My home is far. Your language gives me some trouble. We elves, time for us is now. There is not then and when.
Her eyebrows shoot up.
There can be a way. Amiro knows. But he is gone. Do you see him? He knows how to leave. My protector, my friend. An elf like me, with a spirit bright as new leaves. He tries to help me, to save me, and he suffers very much. He is caught by those who hurt him. I wish so much for his return. And he tells you what you seek. A way out. You bring me great peace. Thank you, my friend. I miss him very much. I see something that helps. I see a lizard. He is a lizard of many dreams, of far feeling. You do not free Amiro without him.
You are in the wrong place, Pinky. Fear. Pity, perhaps. A blind wolf may lead the pack, but sooner or later they will all starve. Never mind. If you need to suit up, I can offer you a fair price. If not, I would thank you to move on. You are in the wrong place, Pinky. You are in the wrong place, Pinky.
Frightfully busy at the moment, love. Haven't got any liquor on hand, have you? This fella could use a little comfort. Well, look at that. Just what I ordered. Ain't you a peach, love? An old dean here would thank you too if he could. Poor fella over there crossed one of Griff's card sharks and got a club to the skull. Doomed to be sure, but I'd like to ease his way out. A healer's walk is never done. Unless everyone's dead, of course.
Clam.
Here you are. I wonder what keeps you. Tell me your tale. We are unfamiliar, yet familiar. We are the same material, you agree? I am very curious. So tell me. Tell me your tale. Start from the beginning. Start from where you come. I see, I see. Now tell me more. Tell me what you do. Tell me what you find. I understand. Now tell me how your story ends. I see it in your shoulders, the weight you carry. I hope your wish comes true. Take this rope. It is a gift. It is common, but it helps you lift burdens. It is nothing. Many fragments swirl on my shore. See what I gather.
The woman looks out on the gently lapping waves. She seems totally at peace, but as you approach, she turns to you with a cheerful smile.
Haven't seen you around here before. Well, you here alone?
She gives you a long...
You think twice about facing this mean world alone, eh? Some of us haven't got anyone at all anymore. It's nothing. If I haven't learnt that by now, I haven't learnt anything at all. Used to be I had a family. A husband and a little boy. We were healers. Source was in our blood. Then they brought us here. I couldn't stop them from taking my boys from me when they did. Reckon they were cured. Maybe even released. Don't know why the Reds didn't take me, too. Now I'm just waiting for him to call my name. Waiting and remembering. Thank you kindly, sweetheart. I do appreciate it. They were good lads. Too good for this place. In some ways, I'm glad they got out quickly.
Listen to me bubbling on like a cauldron. You're sweet to listen. And yes, they were lovely. Totally lovely. I'll see him again before I'm gone for good. That's for certain. You run along now, darling. You shouldn't spend what little time you've got left here listening to an old bleeding heart moan.
Come on, you stubborn hunk of
The dwarf's fingers clamp around a splintered chunk of wood nailed to the skeleton of an old ship. His whole body strains with the effort of wrenching the plank free, to no avail.
Ah.
got two of my own, haven't I?
The dwarf spits into each of his calloused palms and rubs them together before placing them both back on the plank and pulling.
Bleeding nail must be charmed or something. Go on then.
You grab the plank.
Oh, look at that. Nice of you to finish the job after I loosened her up.
You get a good look at the hearty fellow, broad as a hull and sunburnt from all sides. His beard is a cascade of meticulous plaits, each one braided through with golden medallions. He winks and flips a gold coin toward you. It makes a long, high arc, glinting in the sun, and lands squarely in your hand.
For your trouble. No, but I'd hoped to build something with it that would be worth 1,000. Yeah, it were a fool's errand thinking I could make something out of this heap, but I couldn't help myself from trying.
He sucks a finger and holds it up to the wind, testing the breeze.
Winds like these, she would have capsized before she reached the break. Well, on to plan B.
He gives you a wry look, as though deciding whether to trust you.
Aye. Was planning to build me a raft and paddle off. I've got business north of here, in a town called Driftwood. Far be it from me to miss an appointment. Why don't we make a deal then? You help me get out of this place, and I'll do the same for you. That's the spirit.
He lifts an invisible cap and bows with the grace of a courtier.
Pleased to make your acquaintance. The name's... Well, the name's dead and buried. What matters is what they call me. Beast. May have been cast out, but you can bet your last heel of breed she wishes she hadn't of. I've taken my revenge 1,000-fold on that tyrant's fleet. I'll tell you when you're older. Anyhow, we're a team now, so the me is not half as important as the us. Let's get down to brass tacks. Fighting, I mean. I've been up and down the realm so often it'd make your cabbage spin, and I picked up a few tricks along the way. Truth be told, I've grown fond of crushing and casting. A battle mage, if you like. But there's not so important as team dynamics. So what'll it be? I've more muscle in an inch than most have got in a mile. What do you have in mind in particular? Then it's settled. Capital! Well, that's that sorted. Onward then. I've got to get out of here, and soon. And I suppose you do too.
machine. That's your fifth flu just to this.
The woman is scrabbling at her throat as though she can hardly breathe.
Shh! Quiet! Better if they don't take notice. They'll only make it tighter. Oh, it won't budge. I can't breathe.
She breathes deeply into the pouch and begins to calm.
Thank you.
Looky, looky here, mates. A fresh face. Why don't you join us in a round of cards? First hands on the house. Chuff to you, Chief. Here are your cards. You're up first.
You glance at your hand. Two purple monarchs. A hard hand to beat.
Well, that was easy. Looks like you'll have to pay your interment fee after all, Freshy. Blaming a bloke you just met for your misfortune, are ya? Ease off, or I'll go ahead and double what you owe. To be sure, Chief. Pay up, and you get to keep your eyes. Sounds pretty satisfying, doesn't it? Go on, then. Whatever pennies you've got in your pocket ain't worth my breath. But don't you go telling Griff I was soft on you. Another inmate, but you wouldn't guess it.
You there. You've just arrived, isn't that right? It's just... I've a proposition. Something very worth knowing. But it's hardly a group affair. I only need... Oh, noble. But after the... Good luck with your friends, though. Enjoy your last days in good company, won't you?
Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves did meet so much.
It's a crumbling disaster. Yes.
A delivery. Surely you'll have one.
Scram, snake face.
Here's the goods. Like you wanted.
Got it.
Worse than war rations, these.
Hey. Hi.
beasts.
Griff is slowly, methodically peeling the skin from a potato. As you approach, he looks up, setting the potato, but not the sharp little knife, down on the table.
What? Who's asking?
He smirks and holds the little knife up to the light, watching it glint.
I'm listening. A Miro. Bloody elves. I guess you mean the clown I caught stealing from my kitchen. He's not going anywhere. Caught him red-handed trying to make off with a second crate after he took the first. Went down like a rent boy when we grabbed him. Easy. Supplies. A crate of food, citrus in particular. He'll talk, or he'll die quiet. Ain't been here long, have ya? No one gets to have it all. No one starves anyone else.
He twirls his knife between his fingers.
Divine's gone. This blade is the only god watching over Fortjoy.
Don't tell anyone where you got this, eh?
Everything there? Good.
Perhaps if those bleeding dwarves didn't eat so much.
Here's the goods. Like you wanted.
Take your point then.
Well done. Sometimes, the best way from a situation is the simplest. I hope Griff rests in peace, even if he lives in anger. You helped me. You saved me from a terrible man. But still there is more I ask of you. I know a way out of here, and this I tell you. But there is something else. Sahela, a young girl here. I am her protector, and she is everything. A ruler, a seer, a knower, a child. She cannot be lost here. It is for all our people, for the world. Give me your map. I show you the way out, a secret, dangerous, but it leads to freedom.
I give you this amulet. You must pass it to the elves who still remain. Tell them Sahela is here. They will send help. Please, she is important.
I go to her. I wish you good luck, and I thank you for us all. Sahela, you are all right.
I am fine, Amiru. I am fine. I know.
I sense he. So
this is very good. Sahela is all right. I still protect her. She does not die here. She does not die here. Thank you. Do not forget what I ask of you. Sahela cannot stay here. She is too important, too rare. Our people must find her. I am very weak now. And Sahela says we stay. I do not go where she does not lead. It is not devotion to Sahela, it is devotion to all, to the world. She is very special. She sees how we will survive the void woken, the dead divine. She leads us back home. all of luck to you. Do not forget what I give you. Take it to the elves who roam the mainland. They come here. They save her. They save all of us.
She breaks into a huge, childlike grin as you approach.
One friend brings another home. Thank you. Thank you, my friend. But only you survive the passage. I see it. You are free. We must remain. I see your heart. You want only to help. But if you want to help me, you must go. Alone.
She squeezes your hand.
I do not forget you. Remember me too. I trust them well.
Quite well again. Then we make another attempt. Soon I am quite well again. Then we make another attempt.
Trust them well.
Thank you.
This is very good. Thank you. Do not forget what I ask of you. Sahela cannot... I am very weak now. She is very special. She sees how we will survive. I never hear her speak something untrue. She sees what others cannot. All of luck.
State your business.
The soldier tightens his grip on his spear and looks past you.
My unlikely friend, what do you need? I hear of no escapes. The only way out is through the Magisters, through their cure. Thugs, I can stand, but I fear the Magisters. It gives me great pain. In this cave, we... Ah, my unlikely friend, what do you need?
Amid the squalor of Fort Joy, you suddenly spot an elf with diamond features, regal and radiant, but cold too, and sharper than any knife. She was the one who sat rolling dice in the ship that went under, deciding fates with every roll, or so she said. Her eyes are focused on a lizard some distance away, and you get the distinct feeling he's an unfortunate man indeed to be trapped in her tiger-like gaze. No sooner have these words left your mouth than she turns about and grabs you in a stranglehold. You feel the tip of a long needle being pushed a little ways into your neck.
You caught me off guard. No one catches me off guard. Better tell me who you really are, or this time I'll let my needle do the licking. To you, I am this pressing pain you wish would go away, but won't.
A push, a pivot, and now you suddenly face her, the needle still all too deeply embedded in the side of your throat. Despite the precariousness of your situation, you notice something that remained undetected in the gloom of the ship, a flaw in her diamond features, a curiously shaped scar on her left cheek.
Let me tell you a little story. Once upon a bad old time, a lizard cut this thing, this living scar, into my cheek. The mark of a slave. But now I'm free, of sorts. And I've traced that lizard here, to Fort Joy. I intend to raise the subject with him. No!
She drives the needle in deeper and whispers.
In truth, it does not matter in the least who you really are. You saw me mark my prey. You could warn him, save him, or kill him before I get my chance. That makes you a liability. That makes you needle feed.
A bright sparkle of laughter follows your proposal.
How amusing. I admit I had not seen that twist coming. I was certain the pitiful begging was about to begin. Make your case and do it quickly. Why should I join you? Escape. How you do tickle me. Most of the misguided dears around here would argue such a thing is impossible. A silly thing to say, but then again, I did think catching me off guard was impossible. Oh, little needle mine, what should I do? Push or pull? You know what? Today is a rather fine day. Sunshine and an easy breeze. Yes, I'll let you live. I'll even agree to travel with you, provided we talk to that lizard I mentioned. I'm not quite sure the weather will save him.
With a casual flick of the wrist, she withdraws the needle from your neck and smiles, as if she just invited you to sit down for tea.
Let's discuss our respective roles then, shall we? Yumi and Death will be playing many a round of hide and seek. So, what role would you like me to play? As a rogue, my speciality is stealth. The quick silence of the dagger striking unseen. That said, I'm perfectly lethal wielding any weapon or magic. So, the choice is yours. Suits me fine. Lead on, or better yet, let me take the lead. Then follow me.
You're not quite certain you'll ever sleep soundly with Sibyl in any sort of proximity, but at least she's on your side, for the moment. A single name throbs across your brain. Verdas, Verdas, Verdas! You cover your face with your hands. As the dead man's flesh slides down your throat, you feel his consciousness enter yours. His memories are yours to experience. You are Finn. Your heart is heavy. You know too much. It's all too much. You met him. A bright light blinds you, then fades. You feel a tremendous power in your hands, but they are shaking so hard you can barely use them. Suddenly you're on this very ship, crouched in a corner, hugging your knees. A figure approaches, an older woman. She reaches a hand toward you. The memories end. You are no longer Finn. You eat Griff's hand, and you see him putting animals, dead for days in the blistering sun, whole into his cooking pot. Probably best to pass on the stew. As you're about to approach the lizard, Sabeel cups your chin between thumb and index finger, then guides your eyes to hers.
Listen, I need to have a chat with this here morsel of flesh.
To your surprise, Sabeel proceeds to throttle the unsuspecting lizard with one hand as she drives the tip of her needle into his lower belly with the other. Then the questions commence. You hear him yelp about the master, lone wolves, and a man called Griff. Then, quite suddenly, there's blood everywhere as Stingtail falls to the ground, face first into his own intestines. Sabeel heaves a sigh of satisfaction, and as she wipes her needle clean, shoots you a cursory look.
Chat's over.
That seemed just a tad excessive.
What you witnessed was an exercise in restraint, and jolly good fun to boot.
Something on your mind? It's simple. He scarred me, so I scarred him. Extensively.
She defies you with devilishly innocent eyes.
Can you blame me? There it is. I was wondering when your spying would make an appearance. Anyway, what's dead is done, so let's move on, shall we? Despite my high hopes, this scar disfigures me still. The search for the master continues, of course. Hungry work, the hunt. And you know what? I'm feeling a bit peckish. Stingtail mentioned a cook, as it happens. Fellow named Griff. Two birds, one stone. How about it? A moment's pause. I had thought us too wicked for rest. Thank you. You come to fight. You come to prove yourself. You come to be worthy. There can be only one, and you have but one chance. Good. Who aids you? Choose wisely. Whether you fail or succeed, you...
Thank you. don't become the one by which
one
just a match
walk among
two.
Us, though not to match, it seems.
Someone will yet be chosen.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve
someone
a glory.
Someone will yet be chosen.
You don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Each day brings us one step closer.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
Each day brings us one step closer.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
You don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Someone will yet be chosen.
The one will walk
among us.
You don't
become the one by winning just a match or two.
Someone will yet be chosen.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
Patience does not come easy, however.
I'm the only one with the guts.
Shame in love.
I deserve the glory.
We will yet reveal the one.
Someone will yet be chosen.
Do not lose hope. The one will arrive in time.
My fight is strong. No
Someone will yet be chosen.
Someone
will yet be chosen.
My fight is strong. No way I'll be besting.
Someone will yet be chosen.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
Each day brings us one step closer.
My fight is strong. No way I'll be bested.
Do not lose hope. The one will arrive in time.
Someone will yet be chosen.
I deserve the glory.
The one will arrive in time.
You don't become the one by winning just a match.
Someone
will
yet
walk among
us,
though not today, it seems.
Someone will yet be chosen.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
You cannot hurry the one. Patience does not come easy, however.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve
one will yet be chosen.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
My fight is strong. No way I'll be bested.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
Someone will yet be chosen.
You don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Each day brings us one step closer.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
You don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Someone will yet be chosen.
The one will walk among us, though not today, it seems.
You don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Each day brings us one step closer.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
Each day brings us one step closer.
I'm the only
one
with the guts.
You cannot hurry the one.
I deserve the glory.
Patience does not come easy, however.
Each day brings us one step closer.
Don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Each day brings us one step closer.
Patience does not come easy, however.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
The one will walk among us, though not today, it seems.
Someone will yet be chosen.
You cannot hurry the one. Patience does not come easy.
You don't become the one by winning just a match or two.
Each day brings us one step closer.
Oh, not today, it seems.
My fight is strong. No way I'll be bested.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
Each day brings us one step closer.
There is no shame in loss. We will yet reveal the one.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
Each day brings us one step closer.
The one will walk among us, though not today, it seems.
You may yet be the one. You prove yourself again, and again, and again. A warrior traveling the path of the one should not be collared like a pet. I...
cannot hurry
each
the
day one. Brings us one
patience
step.
Does not come easy, however.
Someone will yet be chosen.
My fight is strong. No way I'll be bested.
The one will walk among us. You cannot hurry the one. Patience does not come easy, however.
Each day brings us one step closer.
The one will walk among us, though not today, it seems.
Each day brings us one step closer.
I'm the only one with the guts. I deserve the glory.
You cannot hurry the one. Patience does not come easy, however.
Well done. Tell me, what is your strategy in the Strategist? I will keep my eye on you.
It's really you. You gave him hell, did you?
She sits at full attention, utterly wrapped in your retelling.
It may just be you. The one. You might be her.
She clasps her blackened hands before her and seems for a moment on the verge of weeping.
Then you're our best hope. You may become the one.
She looks around, checking for prying ears, and lowers her voice.
It would mean everything. The one will prove herself above all others. The one will become divine. You may be the one to save us all. There's only one thing to do. I've got to set you free. Your collar. Let me take it off.
What a privilege on me!
She manipulates the ring around your neck in several quick yet intricate motions. Off pops your collar. And a sense of relief swirls from deep within you.
You hear me now. You get out of this place. You keep fighting. You become the one. And you think of old Nibora when it's all over.
Where's the oil? Where's the oil? Where's the oil?